This is second morning of the season. And we slept in. Boy, did we have a grilling day yesterday. Starting at 4 o'clock in the morning, ending 10 o'clock last night. We went up on Dome Peak, up on the northern end. Looped all the way around through the woods on the backside. We got out near Elk Meadows. We actually heard bugling. One of them pretty close. I think he just didn't want to have anything to do with it, so he squalled a time or two and took off. I think he's a herd bull of cows, and he just didn't want to mess around with us. I think's what the deal was. But anyway, my God, we started back out there, and it started raining. Rained off and on. But it's still coming all the way back to what we call Green Valley, the best way we know to get up in there. We stopped off, we bailed off the mountain before we should have. We got into the gosh awful mess. No way to describe how bad it was. Rock, steep, cliff, gosh almighty. Told Kenny when we finally got back to the four-wheelers, I'm never gonna fuss about riding four-wheelers again. Anyway, the water's full for coffee and breakfast. And Kenny's still in the sack, so we'll see. Talk soon. Now I ask you, doesn't that look like a hard-working elk hunter? Third day of the season, here we sit.
Here we sit, yep.
We have got a beautiful camp spot here. But what the significance this is, Paul, on this cross, and stuck down in here is an elk skull and whiskey bottles. This campsite, boy, somebody's done a lot of work. All the big old logs have been sawed up everywhere. Built a table. They had a stool there, but the stool wasn't worth a flip. The table was good. But anyway, meat pole back there, logs everywhere. Well, we are working, Clint, we're working our way up Buck Mountain. I had to stop and do some repairs to my person. We are working our way up toward Buck up there.
With pretty weather.
Yeah, pretty weather. Kenny decided that what we have had in the past is Clint weather.
Clint Luss weather.
Clint Luck weather, yeah. But Clint ain't here and it's been pretty weather, ain't it?
Yep.
This will be the first call made on Buck Mountain in many, many years. Thank you. sitting up here on a big old knoll on the west side of encampment. Stevens met us right up there. Right up there is old Spike Camp. We're just right across from it. I'm gonna pat around the area here a little bit. Ooh, goodness. Stood up too quick, got dizzy. That over there. That's North Buck Basin. I mean, we're right in the middle of Buck Mountain. Well, there's our Trail Creek stuff that we've been going up. We went right up through that draw there on your right. And it was easy. And you can see we could hide all that country there and come off that mountain. Did we do that? No. In the dark. Instead of going across that, we come down that. Hey, old Mosey. What a nightmare. Anyway, this is where we're at. I think that daggone bull that was bugling the other night was right here in that meadow right there. We were just right there. I think he's down here in this meadow. That right there in the middle is Stevens Creek, Upper Stevens Creek Meadow. Anyway, that's the Knoll. Spike Camp right in the center. Then you go up to those high meadows. Up in there. Right over in there is where Doug Shot is. Right there. That's where Kevin Shot is. And right in that meadow right there is where I cut myself. What country. Oh, and by the way, I don't see a sign of a forest fire over in that area now. You couldn't see the fire from up here, but I think them rains kind of put it out, don't you?
Yep.
Just looking and listening. Well, it's getting late. Heard a couple of bugles way back on North Buck. Kenny spotted a bull and a cow over on South Buck for just a minute. They went back in the timber and haven't been seen since. We've called and stomped and bugled and done everything. They just don't want to seem to fire up at all. We'll give them about 30 more minutes and we're going to have to head off this mountain.
Second storm of the night, no morning. It's been a hard storm last night. Buku, thunder, lightning. And this one started this morning. There is some thunder and lightning with it, but not much. One last night, I wish you were rolling. But anyway, I reckon we'll just stay here in the sack until all this quit. That's one way to get you there.
Well, it's actually third morning of the hunt. But it rained half the night. It's 9:30. It just did quit raining, but I don't know if it's quit for sure or not. It's still cloudy all around. We left the dadgum teepee open. Flap load shut and protected Kenny's stuff and left my side of the tent wet. My seat is soaking wet. But I've got water boiling for breakfast and coffee. Finally, I don't know for how long.